of New Hampshire's business. I'm Fred Coker. A new transatlantic trade and investment agreement could spur new export business for New Hampshire and hundreds of jobs. With me to talk about that is somebody who knows this well. It is Susie Kitchens, who is the Consul General for New England for the United Kingdom. Welcome.
Thank you, Fred.
Nice to have you here. New Hampshire, named after Hampshire County in England. A long time ago, 1629, I did my homework. But today, 10,000 residents work for 11 British companies, so residents of New Hampshire, so we still have a close connection. This transatlantic trade and investment partnership, let me put a graphic up on the screen first. And here it is. Proposed free trade agreement between the U.S. and the EU, including the United Kingdom, would lower barriers to trade. In fact, it would eliminate all trade but tariffs. It could be finalized by the end of this year. New Hampshire exports, already about $869 million, could increase, and we'll talk about that. They could increase as much as $350 million and bring another 700 jobs. Where is this agreement right now? Where is this? What's the status?
Well, the agreement's going through a series of negotiations, some taking place in Brussels at the heart of the EU, some in Washington, D.C. But we have teams of experts who are working through the really gritty detail in the hopes that we will come out of this with a really ambitious and comprehensive free trade agreement, something that will benefit both the U.S. and the EU, but also the world by setting new geopolitical standards for trade and international
investment. Besides lowering the tariffs, what else does it do? What else is it proposed to do?
Well, it will harmonize some standards, and it will create some new standards in jobs and sectors that haven't had standards set before. So we're in a new age of innovation and technology,
right.
And we're looking to provide a framework for international trade in those sectors.
Right, and now in the numbers that you have provided and others, I have come to the conclusion about another $350 million in export business for New Hampshire and about another 700 jobs. That's significant.
It's very significant. I mean, already New Hampshire's exports, both in goods and services, about a quarter of those go to the EU, and we could see that quantity increase by a quarter of itself. So that really is huge potential there for increasing the market for New Hampshire and creating jobs.
And your job as Consul General in New England is to promote that kind of trade and agreement between the UK and the New England states.
Absolutely. I mean, the business relationship between New England and the UK is fundamental to the relationship, and it underpins the prosperity of this region and the UK, so it's very important to me.
Now, let me put up an ad, and this is Boris Johnson, who is the Mayor of London, actually born in New York, as you well know, but he's now the Mayor of London and has dual citizenship, and he's coming to Boston in February.
That's right.
And this fellow is popular, rather unorthodox, I understand, and you have tweeted that hold on to your hat, and also Santa may be coming to town this month, but look who's coming to Boston in February. Talk about Boris Johnson. Why is he coming?
Well, Mayor Johnson is probably the closest thing we have to political celebrity. He's incredibly well known throughout the UK. He's a very vibrant and colourful politician.
Yep.
And his role at the moment is to promote London as a city. Mm-hmm. So he takes trade missions overseas to promote London's business sectors. We're very strong, as you know, in financial services. He's also promoting Tech City and the new life sciences centre we're developing in London called Med City. So he's coming out to talk about connections and jobs and growth that we can make with New England.
Tell him we'd like to see him in New Hampshire with his very special hairdo.
We'd love to take him on the road.
Okay. Finally, the Home Secretary was in Boston in September. She came to talk about the security situation that London and Boston have in common, the bombings, in other words, to talk about counter-radicalism and community policing. And just talk about that.
Yes, so Theresa May, our Home Secretary, has a very broad portfolio that includes security. She's done a lot of work looking at the UK foreign fighters, as we call them, what's happening with UK people who've been radicalized and have gone overseas, and how we can protect ourselves from that and stop it happening
now
again.
We can learn from that here in the Boston and New England area.
Exactly.
Okay. All too short, Susie Kitchens, who's the Consul General for the United Kingdom in New England. Thank you. Nice to have you back here at Channel 9.
Thank you very much.
And if you missed part of the interview, you can see it again at WMUR.com. Click on News and then click on Project Economy.